Hi everyone, welcome back to the Navigant Credit Union Broadcast Center. Of course, I'm Go Local News Editor Kate Nagel, Jeremy Duffy with Isle Brewers Guild, and
you?
Pawtucket coming in to tell us everything that's going on with the Guild. Just open the spring.
Correct. So we purchased a facility in Pawtucket, an old industrial building, so it was great to rehab it. We did that about 18 months ago. 2016 was all about the build out and getting the brew house ready. And then, yes, in March, we started brewing our first beer, which is actually right here.
Which was the first one?
Which is, ironically, it is Narragansett, which is phenomenal. So it's the first beer that we did right here.
Now, it says it's about time. Was that
correct?
Sort of a double entendre?
Absolutely. for two reasons. Yes. One, primarily, for us, we finally got, after 3 years of working on this venture, we got this going. But more importantly, that Narragansett, for the first time since 1983, start brewing in Rhode Island again.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's why it's about time.
It's about time. How would you describe the it's about time?
So it is American IPA. There's an East Coast IPA style, which is usually a double IPA. There's a West Coast style. This is more of a malt forward IPA, which would be American IPA.
Okay.
So it's awesome.
It's about time.
Yeah,
and you've got some other ones here. And I do want to just tell folks that when you came in, just had some great national press. USA Today was talking about Mancations with Father's Day coming up.
Absolutely.
And they mentioned you guys.
Yeah, which is awesome, right? So we've been really lucky with some great press locally and nationally about what we're trying to do. And just a little bit of the concept so people know is that we are what we would define as a partnership brewery. So with craft beer absolutely taking off regionally but also nationally, there's been a real issue about meeting demand.
Mm.
So we are now working with five great New England breweries to be able to help them sort of replicate and bring their best products to market. And in this case, that was Narragansett. So
okay,
really
so
thrilled.
Narragansett. So when they put you on that list for USA Today and they say Mancation,
yeah,
if you're going to the Isle Brewers Guild, what's a tour like? What can someone expect when you go?
So we have now rebranded the campus the Guild. Right, it's just a cooler name. It really defines what the concept is a collective of artisans and craftsmen coming together. It's a medieval term, which is perfect. And so what you can do is right now the tap room is open. So we open our tap room, which is now inside the brew house, which is the largest American-made craft brew house in the country right now,
wow,
and one of the largest in New England. You can go into the tap room right now. It's open on Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Hours are on theguildri.com. And you can sample. We have eight beers right now that you can sample. It also allows, we have a really beautiful mezzanine that you can go up and you can see all the equipment. We have eight fermentation tanks, seven that are 300 barrels that hold 100,000 glasses of beer.
That's a lot of beer.
That's a lot of
That's
beer.
A lot of
That's
beer.
A lot of beer. So you really can able to experience that. And then within the next month or so, we will add the tours that will include the brew house, but also the packaging hall, which will be great.
I can see how it's packaged. So when you say eight, so can they make eight beers at any given time?
Is correct.
That,
so okay, we have eight fermentation tanks. So you can brew a beer within a half a day.
I was going to say the time
on the
frame.
Style.
Wow.
But just like wine or whiskey, etc., it goes into a fermentation process. And really just depends on the style of beer.
it's always good in the Go Local Studios. You never see who you see walking by.
Yeah.
We're not going to add them.
Yeah, my lawyer. just checking up on me.
Making sure you are where you said you are.
Yeah, exactly. That was funny. So I love this skate. So basically, we have eight fermentation tanks. It's going to range from like 14 days to 21 days, depending on the style. So that's going to really hold up the production side of things. So that's why we have eight tap lines, because we can do eight beers.
Okay.
Right now. But that, right now, if we had all the tanks filled, that's about 850,000 glasses of beer at one time.
That's just a little bit
just
of beer.
Just a little bit.
So this was the first one.
Correct.
Okay. So
correct,
we're going to move this one and talk with us about the other ones that you have brought in here as well.
Absolutely. So four of our beer partners are, we have Devil's Purse, which is out of Cape Cod, a great young brewery. They're doing some great stuff. So they have two flagships. This is the Kolsch, which is a German-style Pilsner. And then they have the ESB, which is the English Special Bitter, which is also an ale, but just a different, very English style, which is not really produced that much.
Mm.
So what's very cool is that they're both doing very low ABV, sessionable beers that are great for the summertime and are crushing it. They're doing so well. So
what's,
great guys.
What's a low ABV?
So I'm sorry.
There?
So
alcohol with a low.
Yeah, correct. So IPAs have a tendency to have a high alcohol content, mm-hmm. right? Really about 7%. Just to level set it, Budweiser could be about 4.5. So when we call sessionable craft beers, they're usually playing in the fours.
Okay.
Which means you can
have a couple
more than one
yeah.
without really being affected. Let's
Excellent.
Just say that.
Summertime beers.
Correct. So these guys are great. Please, anyone that's going out to the Cape, visit their brewery. It is awesome.
Okay, the Devil's Purse. Okay, who else do we have over here?
So let's go next with Newburyport. Newburyport, obviously out of Newburyport, Massachusetts. It's been around, they were the fastest growing brewery in Massachusetts when they launched a couple of years ago. Just awesome guys, great beer. And they really have sort of three flagships. This is the most popular, which is the Greenhead IPA. It is a West Coast style IPA. About 7% alcohol content, great flavor, great taste. And this is just flying off the shelves. They also have a pale ale, which we are producing right now. And they have the pale ale, and they have the IPA, and now they're about to do a lager as well, which is great. So these guys are fantastic, and they'll be down next Friday hanging out. So
okay, you can check that out on the Guild. And then last but not least.
So kind of with Narragansett is definitely our local favorite. You know, they've been around forever. Mark Helendron has done a great job with the brand. These guys are really interesting. So one of the things that we're trying to do with the concept is show scope but also scale, right? In this case, this is scope. So right now, this is Farmer Willie's. It's an alcohol craft ginger beer. So it is, there we go. Didn't break anything, look at
the
that.
The reason why I'm taking it off air, I see the very keywords.
Gluten-free
for the celiac community.
Correct, and that's a huge product benefit. So a couple things here. One, low ABV, 4.5, really nice, light, sessionable, perfect for the summertime. Gluten-free to that point, and people that just want a little bit different from sort of traditional craft beer. And these guys, two Brown University graduates, idea came from the Cape, where one of them summered, but really was figured out up on College Hill, which is awesome. So, and they are doing amazing stuff right now.
Would you use this in a dark and stormy? That seems like it'd be very
strong. So I have a concept.
Seems like a deadly combination.
So I talk about how it's really nice, light, and refreshing, but then I talk about the double down effect. So with the dark and stormy, yes, you can double down.
Moscow Mule,
double down.
They have a very strong drink there with us.
And they're making, and they are doing a lot of mixes. So up in Boston, hopefully in Rhode Island soon, they're on tap. And a lot of really the craft cocktail bars are starting to do mixes
to
with
pick
it,
up
which
on
is great.
This.
Yeah, you so should definitely meet the guys.
When you go, I mean, you can go for the tastings, but you can literally buy six packs and walk out.
Correct.
Right?
Yeah, with the new laws in Rhode Island, so you can go in and have a couple pints and really enjoy what's happening. But then you can also buy up to a case of beer, particularly around Father's Day.
Especially around Father's
which
Day.
Is perfect.
And do you help folks know too if someone comes in and says, "I really like the Newburyport"? You know, where can I buy it around me?
Yeah, correct. I mean, we are very supportive of the local restaurants and the liquor stores, right? That's part of the whole family of what we're trying to do. So we absolutely drive people to the sort of great retail locations that they can buy it.
How much beer do you drink a day?
Me?
I'm not sure from a governance
perspective. Just quality control, quality testing. You know, we got to make sure that it's always there. Now, but the tap room's open right now, so yeah, of course, there's one or two pints during the opening days.
So, what can we expect in the future? And how do companies? Do they just approach you if someone's got a concept? Yeah. Do they say, is there a waiting list? Being like, you know, say we want to be part of the co-op. How does that organically sort of move?
That's a great question. So, you know, we had really kind of analyzed the industry, particularly in New England. So all of our brands right now are New England based, and just had and started with conversations, my partner Devin and Kelly and I. And what has happened is that it's sort of a two-way conversation. Not only are they looking for us, because they're very concerned. These are their main lifelines. This is their babies in a lot of regards. And they have to make sure that they can trust us. So there's a lot of conversation. Mm. But we also go to the other side too. We want to make sure, one, the entry has to be great liquid. It has to be great beer, and that's very important to us. And then really kind of liking the management team and liking their story and all that kind of stuff. And so we are really fortunate. We have five partners right now. We are doing the fifth one, as I call it, is and he's been here a couple of times, is Mike Rapucci from Sons of Liberty.
Yes.
We do a malt base for him so he can actually help with his whiskeys and create his whiskeys, which is awesome. It looks like we're going to bring another two craft breweries in the next 30 days or so. One is, I think, well, they're both going to be, people are going to be really excited. One that people are going to really know about and be very excited about. But I'm also getting calls every week about it. And so we're, you know, I'm trying to keep the partnership to a low number because we really want to support these partners, right?
Yes,
we are a sister facility. We are there we work hand in hand with the brewmasters. They come in on brew days, they come in packaging days. We really want to be able to kind of do it that way. So to keep the number small, I think it's very important from a cultural perspective.
So how many people are in the guild in any given day? If you go and you go to the tap room, like who are you going to see around?
Yeah, we're really fortunate right now. We brought an awesome team together. We have about 18 employees right now, which is great, just creating jobs in Rhode Island. Devin and I are both Rhode Islanders, so to be able to do something here is really, really important to us. So on the brew team, we have five brewers on staff. Which is great. We have one of the senior brewers from Harpoon has now come to us.
Wow.
We really have an excellent team. We were talking to one of the brewer, and we were kind of explaining who we had. And they're like, "How did you even get that group?" You know, from a startup perspective, really impressive. So, and they have just hit the ground running. We've already brewed 6,000 barrels of beer, which is a ton of beer, and they've just absolutely knocked it out of the park. We also have a packaging team of about six. We're just doing canning, obviously. It's like the new craft movement, which is huge. Bottling has almost gone away. So for the whole cycle, one is they're cheaper to buy. They actually store the beer so much better. What really kills beer and good quality beer is light.
Mm-hmm.
So it actually packages it well.
Okay.
From a lifestyle perspective on the beach and boating and outdoor camping lifestyle, backyard barbecues, it's perfect to have. And then you can recycle it. So, you know, so the really the full cycle on that, and that's why the canning has really taken off, and we're happy about that. And then, you know, and then we have a full team of just, you know, on the management side, finance and all that other fun stuff. But really the lifeline is in the brewing and the packaging. And the packaging just has to be just as important as the brewing, mm-hmm. because if you don't package it right, you know, the customer's not going to like it.
Then you're not going to get it out.
Yeah,
so
correct.
Who's coming to the guild? Is it mostly Rhode Islanders? Are you getting a bigger people coming in here as like a mecca? Are they kind of like traveling, making day trips down?
So sorry to use that sort of marketing lingo, but the geotourism around breweries is insane. It's like people travel to do this.
Yep.
And the great thing is Rhode Island is really building an incredible community. You know, there's, I think, over 20 breweries in Rhode Island right now. So what we're seeing is, and we've had between special events and our soft launch, I think we've already had 3,000 people through sort of our tap room and our special events areas, which is awesome. And people have been really, really embracing it. A working brewery, right? It's not, I mean, you're there and you're seeing stacks and pallets and all of that. But really, we're drawing from Massachusetts and Rhode Island. We're drawing from a greater New England craft community that's exciting. But we'll have people all the time like, yep, we're here from Texas and we heard you're open and we just want to sample your products.
And come and check it out.
Come and check it out. It's awesome.
So you've got a couple of, as you said, brewers interested in that. You know, you've got a lot of demand. So what's the long-term picture for the guild?
So we can, with a 100-barrel brew house, which again is one of the largest ones in New England, absolutely, we're the largest by far in Rhode Island. We can grow. So we can go up to 60,000 barrels with just our tanks right now. We can add more tanks to go to 100,000 barrels and then ultimately tap out at 150,000 barrels.
That's
from a production standpoint, but from the campus, the guild perspective, I'm really excited because we have our temporary tap room open right now. The mezzanine is open for people to come in and have pints and enjoy themselves, but we're building out an outdoor beer garden. We're also, in 2018, having a beer hall, about 5,500 square feet beer hall.
A beer hall, like German style?
We have long tables and a long bar, and it'll be awesome. And really, it's about community, right? So when we want people to show up, we want people to hang out, right? I mean, there is the whole family sometimes shows up. If you go to the great craft breweries, it's really kind of a sort of family activity, right? And
so you get sodas for the kids?
People, yes, we do, and water. So
any food?
So we're doing food trucks right now. So we got a great barbecue food truck showing up right now. It's actually trying to win a national award. Working with the food truck community, we actually had the food truck awards on Monday night at the brewery. We had over 400 people show up, and it was a great night.
Okay.
Really, really good.
Combination of food and beer, all things going on.
And music as well. So we have music tonight. So on Fridays and Saturdays, we have music, which is perfect for what we're trying to do.
Have some drinks, have some great beer, listen to some music. So where should folks go for more information?
So they can go to theguildri.com.
Okay. Check it out. Well, Jeremy Duffy with The Guild, I appreciate your coming in. Again, go check it out. Buy some beer for Dad.
Yeah. Happy Father's Day.
Happy Father's Day, everybody. Jeremy, thanks for coming
in. Thanks so much.
Okay.